Adrian, our camera operator, has given Jane his camera so she's completely alone in the house. Ian and I will be watching Jane's every move from the nerve centre.
It's gone freezing cold right behind me. Shit, I don't even want to turn around.
Are you standing by me now? Are you behind me?
Friendly.
Friendly?
Wow.
So you're friendly. Good. Thank you. Is this Frank? Frank, are you the friendly spirit? The protective spirit? Okay, I'm going to move. I'm going upstairs. Keep talking to me, Frank. If you're down there, follow me. Where are you, Frank?
I think she'll start feeling.
Me to where you are?
She'll feel something as soon as she gets Frank? In the hallway again.
Where are you?
Whoa.
What was that?
What did you hear, Jane?
The whimper, like cry, like woo. This is not creepy at all, is it?
I think because she's on her own, it's starting to be more active.
If you're upstairs, I'm coming up now as well. I'm on my own. Husband. What?
Husband? Jane, maybe they
were trying to elope or get married or something.
Yeah. Right, I'm gonna go into Alex's bedroom. Oh my God, this room feels totally different. It didn't announce the word. Wife.
Wife,
so we've had husband. And wife.
Brilliant.
That's absolutely incredible. Well done, Jane.
So Frank is telling us potentially he wanted to be a husband. Rom, and she is saying she wanted to be his wife.
Yeah. Seriously, there are 9,500 words in that word bank.
Yeah.
Whoa. What was that?
That's like both spirits are communicating with her at once.
100%.
And it's reference. Them being lovers,
yeah.
Being wanting to be husband and wife, but we never got the chance.
But over there, behind me, I've just heard something in there. Who's that? There was a knock.
We're going to come in and
join you up in Alex's room and bring the ghost box with us.
Yeah, good idea.
So it's Jane.
That was insane. The husband and wife thing, what are the chances of getting those two words, husband and wife?
Straight after each other.
Yeah.
Jane's made great contact with what we think are the spirits of Edith and Frank, and I want to continue this communication in Jim and Sam's bedroom.
Whoa. Can you feel that?
Yeah, there's a load.
It's cold.
It's cold.
It's weird, isn't it?
Feels weird.
We're using Echovox again to try to communicate with the spirit who's been touching and moving Jim and Sam while they sleep.
Frank?
Yeah.
Did you pull Jim out of the bed?
Yes.
That was a yes.
Why did you feel the need to pull Jim out of the bed? Was it a fire? Could you smell burning?
Yes.
Was that a yes as well?
Did you both die in a fire?
That was a woman say yes.
Mm.
Did you try and save Edith?
Aye.
Now, aye is a northern word for yes.
Yeah.
Frank. Did you perish in a fire?
Yeah.
So, yes, died, yeah.
Yeah.
Pray.
Pray.
We are going to pray for you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. Yes, good. We will pray for you, I promise. We're going to send you into the light together.
So we've identified Edith and Frank, but we know that there were three spirits here at the start of our investigation.
Should we head to the lounge area and try to make contact with this third spirit?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to be using an SLS, or structured light sensor camera, which detects spirit forms invisible to the naked eye, showing them on screen as stick figures.
On my walk around, I picked up on a man on a crutch.
Well, do you know what? We haven't discussed this yet, but when I met with Jimmy, he also told me about a different use for this building during World War One, and actually it was used as a convalescent home.
Oh,
so
wow.
Wounded soldiers, usually officers, mm-hmm. were sent out to places like this in the countryside for fresh air to recover.
I'm wondering if this is the other gentleman that I was seeing.
But do you think this spirit's responsible for the oppressive feeling? And also, whoever slammed the kitchen door?
Yeah. See, I saw a crutch, but I'm wondering if he lost a leg or something like that, so that could be his frustration.
Yeah.
I feel he's here. I do sense him in the room.
It does feel like there's someone down here with
there
us.
There is. I think he's here, Jane. Jane's actually sensing somebody here as well, so...
Over there.
Can you show yourself to this gentleman I'm touching now? Can you walk towards him, please?
Whoa!
Something's walked through my grey, man.
Sorry, mate. It's because I asked him to. That's my fault. Can you try and show yourself rather than walk through him?
Ian?
Yeah?
There's a small stick figure literally on your head.
Okay, so he stood behind me potentially. John, I don't know, it sounds really stupid because I don't know whether that name is embedded with me now, but I am hearing Patrick.
Are you?
Yeah, I am, yeah. I think it's important that we move Patrick to the light so his conditions are lifted from him and he's at peace. And Frank and Edith, we put them together because it was meant to be together, but it never happened.
We light a candle for the spirits to focus on as Ian tries to help them cross over.
Dear Father, we pray for you to bring down your light of love and happiness. Frank and Edith, we pray for your souls. I ask of you to draw forward towards my voice and focus on this light. You can be together as partners, husband and wife. And as you walk through on the other side, you're embraced as a couple with God's blessing. I'm calling out to the soldier. As you walk through into that light, your conditions are lifted from you. God bless you, my son. We thank you, dear Lord, for opening your doorway of love and light and happiness. And we ask of you to spread that love around each room, each wall. Amen.
Amen.